good evening. We are Culture Club. And this really is quite a beautiful setting. I think it's the first time I've been out anywhere like this. How are you all? I'm quite liking the fact that you're looking down on me. It's a much better look than your usual concert setup where everyone's looking up your nose. So feel free to take as many photographs as you like. Tonight we'll be singing some of our familiar battle hymns, chucking in a couple of new songs for the very brave of you, and taking you on a little bit of a musical journey. This one's called It's a Miracle. And please don't be shy. Sure, what's going to happen if I come too close? I mean, with the sound, I don't mean with you, I'm not scared of you. And I hope you're not too scared of me. There's always that funny sort of period when you first come on stage because people don't know what you're going to do. First of all, it's been a while since we've been out here. So there's that sort of, what are they going to do? Well, we're going to be Culture Club. That's the first thing we're going to do. And we're going to try and get you involved in some way. If only in attitude. You don't really have to do anything. You just have to project positivity. And the key word is always love. And whatever you think it only means the same thing to all of us. I know you, you're from New York. How are you? All the way out here in the wilds. Shall we tumble? So as you can see, we're four shy guys from the UK, and we're joined on stage by some other quite withdrawn characters, as you'll see as the night goes on. That lady over there with the, is that mauve hair?
Purple
hair? Purple hair.
Purple lashes.
Purple lashes, purple hair. You don't seem very shy to me. We'll see. What's that?
Me.
I can't really hear you. Your head.
Never mind. Don't worry.
You may have to whisper in my ear, Mikey, if you want to get intimate. Okay. So this song is, it's a love song, but it's, you know, it's kind of what I would call a British love song, in that it's romantic with a big cynical twist. That's what we do at the Culture Club. We do music that's kind of an oxymoron. Happy, yet sad. Melancholy, but a bit danceable. In some ways, we sum up the human condition because we are quite complicated. I really hope you never have to say this to anyone, but if you do, make sure you mean it. Move away. So this next song was originally recorded by an American band called Bread. First time I heard it was in about 1973, when I was a very, very young boy. And it was recorded by a man called Ken Booth and given a kind of Jamaican flavor, which really took me at that age. And so that's the version we're doing. Now, If you're frightened to stand up, that's okay. You're not really going to risk being in anyone's way because you're all above each other. So we haven't got the usual problems, but if you don't want to stand up, then just kind of move your ass in your seats. You can do a lot of damage. Just, you know. Can we show them, Tracy, that lower down, sitting down thing that we can do? It's very good for your glutes. And equally good for your soul. This one's called Everything I Own. They're still not sure about me, look at them.
Oh.
Thank you. Thank you. So we're going to go now to our album, Colour by Numbers. Some of you look old enough to remember records. And this particular record, I think, was one of our finest. And this particular song, well, I don't really know what it's about. I think I did at the time, but over the years, it's kind of dissipated. So I'll leave it in your hands. You can decide what you think it's about. Because it really belongs to you. And your imaginations. However fruity they may be. Joining me up here is my temporary wife. For the benefit of this song, you and I are estranged lovers.
Okay.
You've stolen my earrings and I want them back. Although those ones are quite small compared to the ones you had on last
night.
They are, aren't they? So the joke was a little bit lost. So next time, can you wear bigger earrings?
Yes, okay. Absolutely.
This is a song called Black Money, and this is Teresa Bailey.
Do you deal in black money? It's black, black money.
And Nick Verdeen on the sax, beautifully played, thank you. Thank you. So, if you're a romantic and you're with someone you love, well done. And if you want to hold them by the hand or put your arm around their shoulder or just, you know, express some feelings of emotion towards them, feel free. We'll just carry on as usual. I don't know what you're up to. This is a song for romantics, but again, it has that kind of wonderful British twist of cynicism, just in case things go wrong. This one's called Time Clock of the Heart. I might start talking in French.
Sing me the river too. This could be the best place yet, but you're mine.
Maybe I'll come a bit closer. Just to see what kind of people are out there. You seem like a very well-behaved, listening kind of crowd. Which doesn't surprise me in a place like this. It seems very laid back. Yeah? Not laid back? Or was that just you? Shut up! If you're one of those people that dives headfirst into love... No, you look beautiful, but I have to concentrate on what I'm doing, sorry. Distraction here, distraction there. This one's called Like I Used To. Somebody help me!
Scattered cushions, I scaled the walls of your ivory tower.
Thank you. So, this next song was written about one of my musical heroes, a man called Sly Stone. He comes from somewhere in Texas called, I think, Denton. Anyone from there? No. And I was reading an interview with Sly Stone in a British newspaper, and he was talking about his rocky existence. Okay. Do we need paramedics? Are you okay? And frankly, Sly Stone makes me look like Mother Teresa. And in this interview, he was saying, I regret many things. I just can't think of one of them right now. So I thought it was quite a funky thing to say. So that interview inspired this song, which is about recovery, redemption, and change. And it's called Different Man. And if you could give me one of your hands, or at least two of them, for a bit of churchiness, I'd be very happy.
Just be, oh, just be.
So we got some of you up dancing, it's beautiful. This one's for you, it's called Miss Be Blind.
Miss me, I know you miss me, I know you miss me blind. I know you miss me, I know you miss me, I know you miss me blind.
Thank you. So we're going to go right back now to almost the beginning. 1982. The first time we came to America to play, our record company had released our first single in a white sleeve so that nobody could see what we looked like. It turned out to be a quite smart move because the first time people really caught sight of us was when we did our first concert in a place called Long Island. The record had been played by a couple of radio stations there, and when we walked out on stage to do our appearance, people were like, it was actually a wonderful, wonderful reaction that I enjoyed very much. We were like aliens that had landed from another planet. And remember, this was in the sort of time of Cheers and things like that. So people were still wearing flared trousers. And here was I in a little sort of frock with some Hebrew writing, Tarabut Agadah, and a little Star of David and some dreadlocks and ribbons, and it was quite a look. In fact, there's a couple of people over there busting that look, and they look rather gorgeous. It's actually back in fashion now, so you're really on point. You look gorgeous. This is a song that really started the whole journey. It's a song called Do You Really Want to Hurt Me? Give me time. Inside your eyes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Woo! This next song is a bit like a tattoo. One of those ones from the 70s that are really hard to get off. It's really inked into my skin and into my life. And it's one of those songs that I've kind of understand more now than I did at the time. It may even make more sense to you. Who knows? I think I'll dedicate this to a lady I met backstage earlier called Shannon, who is super emotional. Because whenever I sing this, I always get very emotional. I try and think about someone special, and maybe you should do the same thing. Show my heart some devotion. Brush aside those that whisper ever. I feel like a child on a dark night. So glad that we could spend it together. People feel the world with narrow confidence, yeah. Like a child at birth, a man with no defense. What's mine's my own, Lord, I won't give it to you. No matter what you say, no matter what you do. Man is far behind love in the search for something new. Like a Philistine, we're burning witches too. Yeah. What's mine's my own love. I won't give it. No matter what you say. Thank you very much. Boy, hey, Maggie Craig, John Mars. Boy, George. Thank you very much.
You really want to make
me cry? So I feel like we should do a little song about chameleons. And you can sing along as loud as you like.
I'm made.
Thank you so much.
Never meant to cause you any pain. I only want to see you one time laughing. Thank you.
introduce the rest of the people up here on stage. On the keyboards, Mr. Carl Hudson.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for a great evening. Thank you.